Morning dear students, yesterday we started our new schedule, that is schedule number 4, substances. Okay, in this the separation of substances, we discuss about the separation, need for the separation and the two methods, these two methods we learn. See, when these two methods are used, separation of solid substances from a mixture means we solid the substances. If two substances are solid and if they mix to each other, then how to separate? For that, these two methods we discussed yesterday. The first one is handpicking method. Simply means just whichever the unwanted substance which is present on that just we have to pick and remove it. Okay, that is the known as a handpicking method. Next one is a threshing. This method is used to separate the grains from stalk. Okay, now the next method is there, that is known as a winnowing. See, the third method to separate the solid substances, that is the winnowing. Now winnowing means what, where this method is used? See, first we will see what is the definition of winnowing, then I will explain you further. See, the method of separating heavier and lighter components. See here, these two words are very important, that is heavier and lighter. See, when this method is used, the method of separating heavier and lighter components of a mixture by wind or blowing air. See, how it is separated with the help of wind and blowing air is called as a winnowing. Then just think about where this method is used. See, this method is used to separate lighter and heavier particles. Okay, and how it is separated? With the help of wind or blowing air. Do you remember something? See, this method mostly the farmers are used, means winnowing method. Okay, means I'm just giving you example. When they separated grains and husk. Okay, grains may be rice and wheat, and husk you know. So which is a lighter in this, grains or husk? Grain are heavier than the husk, and husk are the lighter parts. Okay, so these can be separated with the help of this method. See here, one picture is shown here. In this picture, the winnowing, how to separate the husk from grain. Okay, it is shown in this picture. This method to separate, using this method to separate husk from grain. Okay, so do you understand the winnowing method? And see, mostly your home also, sometimes your mother is used to separate. Okay, so this is a very simple method to separate the heavier and lighter particles. Now, the next fourth one method is there, that is a sieving. In this word only the meaning is hidden. See, you know, okay, every day morning whenever you drink tea, I know that you are not drinking tea, but maybe you observe that. Okay, so that time what your mother is using, tea strainer she is using to separate, what to separate? The tea powder. So that is only known as a sieve. And when this method is used, see here, the method of separation, the components of a mixture that are different size by using a sieve is called as a sieving. Means in this method, if the two substances size are different and we want to separate it, okay, for that purpose we are going to use this sieving method. But the most essential point is the size should be different. Okay, if the two substances size is different, then we can separate this with the help of sieving method. Maybe you observe a construction areas. Okay, there they are using a big sieve to separate the pebbles and stone from sand. You observe that. Okay, so that method is known as a sieving. Why? Because the pebbles are and stones are bigger in size than the sand, so they can separate easily. See here, picture is shown here, how they are doing this man is doing this separation process. Okay, so this method is known as a sieving method. And See, these the four methods means hand picking, threshing, winnowing and sieving. These simple methods we are using to separate the solid substances. If two solids are mixed together and if we want to separate it, then how to separate, which method we have to use. So these four methods are useful for us. Now we will discuss the next point, that is the separation of insoluble solids from a liquid. See, before this we learn how to separate two solid substances and which methods we have to use. See, we discuss about the sieving method. Okay, see, actually this is the wire gauze, but how it is, the netted like structure is there. See, like that it is the sieve we are using to separate pebbles of sand or any whichever the size and shape is different. If you want to separate that, you can use this. Okay, now in this point, the next point, that is the separation of insoluble solids. See, now insoluble solids, now insoluble solids means what? Those are not dissolved in a water, that is known as an insoluble substance. Okay, and means these insoluble solids we have to separate from a liquid, means it is a water. Okay, now how to separate that? For that we will see now. See, the first method is the sedimentation and decantation. Okay, which is the first method? See here, the first method is sedimentation and decantation. Now what exactly is sedimentation? See, whenever the two substances, means one is a liquid and one is a solid, and if it is insoluble in liquid and if density is more, means it is heavier than liquid, then it will be settled down. Okay, so now this we are going to perform the activity. Now here, see, the insoluble substance that are heavier than the liquid can be separated by sedimentation and decantation method. Okay, for example, we will see sand and water. Now see, this is a petri dish. In this petri dish, sand is there. This one is beaker. This is known as a stirrer. This is a spatula. And this is also beaker. Now we will perform the activity. Okay, now see, what we have to take? Liquid means water we will take in one beaker. Just see here. Okay, in this water we are going to add sand. See, activity, it is given in your textbook, activity number 3. Just check it and stir it like this and keep this way for 5 minutes. After some time, what will happen? The heavier particles will be settled down. See, now here, are you able to see this? See the downside layer, sand, this is known as a sediment. Okay, the downside one layer is, I will add more sand then. See here, the downside layer is known as a sediment. Okay, and this process is known as a sediment. The next we will see what is the decantation. See, this solution or this mixture you have to keep for 5 to 10 minutes. After that, the two layers you can see easily, and this water, now the here see water level, water is there. This water we have to separate in another beaker. See. Water be separated. To pour in this water in another beaker, that method is known as a decantation. Okay, so this is the first method, that is the sedimentation and decantation to separate insoluble particles. Now see, sand is insoluble in water, Okay, so we can separate it easily. This process is a decantation to separate this water in another beaker. Do you understand the first method, that is a sedimentation and decantation? This activity is given in your textbook, just read it. Now one more example we will see, that is the immiscible liquids. Now immiscible liquid means what? Those are not mixed to each other. See, insoluble when we use, if the substance is a solid in state, then for that we are using the insoluble substance. But now see, this water is in a liquid state. Okay, and in this water, if we will add one more liquid, and but it will not mix to each other, means what? It is a immiscible liquids. Okay, for example, oil and water. Now we will see, I will add in this little amount of oil. See here, see, oil layer is a separate, one layer is there, and water layer is there. Okay, so these two are not mixed to each other, means what? These are the immiscible liquids. For these method, suppose we want to separate it, then the same method we have to use is with decantation. Now this oil you can separate in another beaker. See, oil we can separate. So this sedimentation and decantation method we can use for the insoluble solids from a liquid and immiscible liquids. Okay, do you understand this method, sedimentation and decantation? In next period we will see